Woke up early this morning around 4 a.m. with the moon shining bright as headlights on the interstate. I pulled the covers over my head and tried to catch some sleep, but thoughts of us kept keeping me awake. Ever since you found yourself in someone else's arms, I've been trying my best to get along. That's okay, there's nothing left to say, but take your records, take your freedom, take your memories, I don't need them. Take your space and take your reasons, but you'll think of me. And take your cat and leave my sweater, cause we have nothing left to weather. In fact, I feel a whole lot better, but you'll think of me, you'll think of me. Driving, trying to clear my head, I try to sweep out all the rooms that my emotions left. I guess I'm feeling just a little tired of this and all the baggage that seems to still exist. It seems the only blessing I have left to my name is not knowing what we could have been, what we should have been. So take your records, take your freedom, take your memories, I don't need them. Take your space and take your reasons, but you'll think of me. Take your cat and leave my sweater, cause we have nothing left to weather. In fact, I'll feel a whole lot better, but you'll think of me. Someday your mind, but don't worry, I'll be fine. I'm gonna be alright. While you're sleeping with your pride, wishing I could hold you tight, I'll be over you and on with my life. So take your records, take your freedom, take your memories, I don't need them. Take your cat and leave my sweater, cause we have nothing left to weather. In fact, I'll feel a whole lot better, but you'll think of me. So take your records, take your freedom, take your memories, I don't need them. Take your space and all your reasons, but you'll think of me. And take your cat, my sweater, cause we got nothing left to weather. In fact, I'll feel a whole lot better when you think of me. You think of me.
Sometimes you just put on comfortable clothes, some kind of music that you might like, be comfortable, and just sketch away. No worries. I'm doing a self-portrait. Muscle to control Goofy's ear, and then a nice, long, beautiful, sweeping line. Just keep keep it thin at the top and have it open up like a long teardrop down at the bottom. Kind of like that. If it doesn't look right, that's just because I need to add a neck. That should help a little bit. Right. It's getting coming together. Looking kind of fun. Little hairs at the top. We're gonna make his hat now. We just take like a dog's dish. We'll put it on top of his head. Like that. You see that move? It's really just a line right there. It's behind his hair. The thin line that comes up. Another line that comes up from behind his head. And then we just wrap this nice curvy line around it. Just like that. Now I'm going to move this down and go to the next clean page so I can show you how to do the rest of his hat. Just want to arrange my paper here so I can clip it on. It's all loose paper and I don't want it to fall. I think that should do it. So now I've just added more paper at the top that I can draw on just to continue his hat. Really, it's just two more lines that come out of his hat. They're bent lines, not perfectly straight. They may look straight on the camera, but they're not. They're bent just a little bit. And then we just wrap what looks like the top of a heart or a dog's bone. Goofy is a dog. So his hat consists of like three parts. Like a dog's bone, sticking straight up out of a dog's dish or a dog's bowl. Like that. Let me hold the paper together so you can see my lines. See? And then we wrap a dog's collar right around that bone. Kind of like this. This is an older Goofy. This is before all the newfangled fancy changes, but if I can just hold that page up for you, and you can see his hat. Wait. I'm sorry about that. I should have used bigger paper, but I was just in a real relaxed mood, and I just wanted to practice something. His other ear would come down over here. You'd only see this much of it. And there you have it. Other than the two pieces of paper, that's a pretty solid sketch, just to warm up with. Okay, so if you can follow along with that. A neat little Goofy. I'm going to sign it. And my self-portrait is done. Okay. Always do that with the page, because what happens is, always do that by letting it bleed off onto the next page. Because what happens is when you're done, you have this. And that doesn't quite look so bad. The only part I missed, really, was this. So you see how when we put them together, it makes his hat. But really, the ultimate drawing is going to end up like this, and it's much better to have the correct size shape bleed off than try to force it on there. Okay. I think I should just shade in the back of his mouth very quickly. And his nose. And see if this doesn't just come to life a little bit more for you. With his eyes and his nose and the back of his mouth. Shade it in a little bit more. See, maybe that helps. See? It's amazing how the contrast will bring him a little bit more to life. Of course, his head and his eyebrows would all be shaded in. His ears. There's a lot of black and Goofy. Of course, I'm using blue, but you understand what I'm saying. I'm going to slide my pencil right through my signature for that one ear. And right down the other ear. Just to really give him... Oh, and of course his neck. But if you ever wanted to draw Goofy step by step, there's one version of him. It's an older version. In this particular drawing, we'll also shade the band around his hat. Very funny hat. Like that. And there you have it. Step by step for Goofy. I tried to do it without explaining. Just let the lines kind of do the work. Okay. Now I feel warmed up. I'm ready to do something really cool. Thank you, guys.